Hi there. Today's movie review is The Man Who Would Be King, which is a real adventure story set in the classic mold. And it works because of three main elements. Firstly, the writing, the source material, the book was written by Rudyard Kipling, who was the brilliant chronicler of the British Empire. And his writing, both in prose and poetry, is just superb. Secondly, the directorial skills of John Huston, who, amongst the many films he helmed, was The African Queen, another real great adventure movie. And then thirdly, you had two English stars at the very top of their game. The yarn opens in India, where we meet two British Army sergeants, Danny Dravot, played by Sean Connery, and Peachy Carnahan, played by Michael Caine. And they encounter a local newspaper editor who is actually the Kipling character, played by Christopher Plummer, another very fine actor. And one of the things they find is that Peachy Carnahan and Kipling are both Masons. And that becomes a very significant thing later on. And they plan to blackmail a local Raja. But this goes awry. And they return to Kipling's office and tell him that they are fed up and there's no future back home in the UK. So they plan to travel to Kafiristan and seek their fortune. And Kipling wishes them good luck and gives Danny a neck amulet, a Masonic symbol on it, to look after him on his journey. So off they go over the Khyber Pass, avalanches, landfalls, rockfalls, flooded rivers, bandits, every kind of obstacle in the way, but they press on. And along the way they meet a Gurkha, Billy Fish, who is the sole survivor of a British army expedition. And he's played by Saeed Jaffrey, and he almost steals the movie. And when you consider the acting chops of Sean Connery, Michael Caine and Christopher Plummer, that's quite a feat. Absolutely terrific performance. So they reach, he joins up with them, and they reach Kafiristan, and the two neighbouring tribes are at war, which is very common in the region right through to today. And they pick a side and start helping them, training them and giving them modern tactics, and they win. But during the big battle, Danny takes an arrow in his chest, but it hits his leather bandolier and doesn't penetrate. However, the tribe thinks that he's immortal. And when they see the amulet round his neck, the Masonic symbol is the same symbol that Alexander the Great had, and he was the one who conquered Kafiristan. And to them, he was a god, because he came there and then he went back, and they've been awaiting his return ever since. And they think that Danny is Sikandar, that's their name for Alexander. So he's delighted at this, and he becomes the king, but he's actually a god. And this unlocks the treasure trove that they've been keeping for the return, unlimited wealth of jewels and gold. And Peachy is allowed a share of this, and he plans to make his way back with his share, because Danny wants to stay and revel in being the king, particularly since they have put up a local girl, a very beautiful girl, Roxanne, to be his wife, and they're going to get married the next day. And she's played by Shakira Kane, Michael Caine's wife, and she was a former Miss Guyana in the Miss World contest. And the story of how Michael Caine wooed Shakira is a tale in itself. It's a lovely story. Anyway, it all goes tragically wrong, and I won't spoil the ending, but there is an epilogue back in Kipling's newspaper office where he finds out what happened to the two soldiers. Absolutely brilliant adventure story. They don't seem to make that kind of movie anymore. They kind of make the more Marvel type films and sci-fi and action heroes, not action heroes, but comic heroes type films. Lots of computer graphics. Whereas this movie was made on location, hundreds of extras, battle scenes, fantastic backdrops of the mountains, the clear skies, the scenes in India, you know, the crowded streets and so on. Brilliant, brilliantly directed. It's certainly one of my favourite films. I'd say it's in my top five, and it was also the favourite film of both Sean Connery and Michael Caine. So there's a lot of chemistry going on. Everyone seems to have had a great time making it. It was John Huston's lifelong ambition ever since he read the book to make this film, and various actors had been proposed in the past, but I don't think they could have done better than the cast they ended up with. The movie's still available. I think you can see it on YouTube. I'll put the link to the trailer. But if you like a really great, a sweeping adventure story, this is the one for you.